Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
Deal?
Boing.
Welcome to the Acquia podcast, Drupal technology, community, and business.
Welcome to the Acquia podcast, Drupal technology, community, and business.
There's a module for that?
There, of course there is.
So here we are in Cologne, early morning on a late summer day, and I've come into the Cologne Trade Fair, and we're at dmexco, which is an interesting place for Drupal people, I think, and certainly a very different world to the one we're used to seeing at conferences. Right now the conference isn't open to the public yet, these are just exhibitors coming in still, so this is going to be big. The organizers have said they're expecting 50,000 visitors, which is pretty exciting. And frankly, that's a kind of a, you know, much, much bigger than your average DrupalCon or DrupalCamp or most tech events that I end up going to. So pretty keen to see what's going on. We've arrived at Hall 8. So this is the sort of thing that we're talking about. This is a single exhibitor's stand. This looks like it must be just the people who are working here. That's much bigger than Acquia. So Hall 8, where we are right now, is a hall for larger exhibitors. There are only maybe, I'm not sure, 100, 150 exhibitors in here. There are other halls with much smaller stands. This is a trade fair for marketing and advertising, and so everyone who's involved in that seems to be here. And I think one of the things that I want to ask people about today in our area is the fact that, you know, Acquia is here, but we're not selling Drupal, in air quotes. You know, we are, in fact, connecting our technology to this other level of business. And I think that that's something that I want to ask people about today. So here we are at the Acquia booth at dmexco 2016. We've got lots of couches and we've got lots of partners here as well. Morning, gentlemen.
Good morning. Good morning.
Can I buy a Drupal here? The theme of our booth this year is all around personalization. Personalization happens. In terms of personalization, we have a hairdresser here. So anyone who wants to come to the stand can have their hair done. And in a while, we're going to have a tattoo artist as well. So I guess we're going full hipster as well. Gentlemen.
Hey, Jam, how's it going?
Good morning.
How's things?
All right. Can we buy a Drupal from you today?
You can buy a Drupal. We've got three available.
Of course.
Going fast. Hey, so welcome to the Acquia podcast, and welcome to Cologne, my hometown, and welcome to the Acquia booth at dmexco 2016. Do you want to talk for a minute?
Yeah, sure.
So I was just saying that, well, first of all, you know, we're right next to Amazon. Oracle is down the lane. I've seen PayPal, the Axel Springer Verlag there, which is one of the biggest publishers in the German-speaking world.
I got a message from Spotify in my feed.
I
got a message from Spotify in my feed saying they're here. And so, yeah, it's everyone's here.
So this is a really different scene than a DrupalCon or a normal technology conference that I would go to. From your perspective, as a Drupal shop, Acquia partner, etc., what's going on here?
Well, I mean, some of the huge brands here, I think, are quite amazing. I think that's something that, you know, is quite different, actually. I mean, as you say, being right next to Amazon is pretty cool.
I think the thing about this is that this is maybe Europe sort of looking a little bit towards South by Southwest. And because the you know, South by Southwest music conference, film conference, tech conference got added a few years ago, and now really it's the tech guys that pay for all the music and film, because they're the ones with the budgets. And I think, you know, maybe the film and music bit hasn't quite been added on here yet, but it's got that feel of you know, Google stand, Spotify stand. They're trying to draw people in and create an experience, and it's about marketing and it's about business challenges. It's not about tech. It's not really about. It's not the nuts and bolts, it's what people are trying to achieve.
So we are not here to sell Drupal per se, right? There's something else going on.
Yeah, I mean, I think we're here to talk about the benefits of a slightly more open source approach to achieving the same things some of the really huge commercial proprietary organizations are selling at this. You know, we're selling the same thing, we're just selling it in a slightly different way.
Okay, so and that's interesting. And how do you think that we can differentiate successfully?
I think it's about the value add, really. I think it's the value add that Acquia brings to the open source platform along with its partner agencies who are actually able to take the open source platform or that add on those additional services, the greater expertise, the idea that actually you can still have open source software that can bring the benefits of the much larger traditional enterprise approach.
So one of the things that I like about being at Acquia and that Acquia does is that we're connecting our, you know, software hippie open source technology to the business world. And that means that we're generating, so, you know, here by selling a you know, personalization and services for business, right? That's not about the software we use. We're still opening the door for Drupal and getting new users in on doing it.
Absolutely, and we're giving the opportunity to bigger businesses to work with hustlers because, you know, we're a group of hustlers and that's what, you know, big businesses are scared about being disrupted, and the best way to overcome that is to work with some people that are sort of a bit more disruptive themselves, and I think that's something that we can offer.
I read a really great article a few weeks ago, and I'm really convinced now that we, the tech community, we have to stop talking about disruption and we have to start talking about engaging with the world. Like, we're here to help people and do things better, right? And make the world a better place, whatever your definition is for that, right?
Yeah, I mean, I think that's something totally core to Manifesto, to our brand is Manifesto for Change. We collaborate closely with organizations to create positive change. As far as we're concerned, every project we do should leave a legacy with an organization as well as the technical product and project it delivers.
You give great elevator pitch. So to wrap this up, why don't you guys introduce yourselves, what you do, and who you are?
Sure. I'm Simon. I'm COO of Manifesto. We're an agency that creates positive change in the world through collaboration, innovation, and most of all, change.
So you do a lot of NGO, charity, that sort of work, which is huge, which is a huge sector for Drupal, especially in the UK, I've noticed.
Yeah, so my background is working with people like Cancer Research, who are a Drupal and Acquia customer. We look after Frieze Art Fair, create the biggest temporary structure in the world, bring modern art to people every year in New York, and they have a Berlin office and also in London. The fairs are London and New York. I'm Jim Bowes, by the way. I'm one of the founders of Manifesto. I'm the CEO. One of the things I'm most excited about is when we work with an organization and you can see afterwards they've moved on in the way that they do things. And I think for me, that's what we're about.
Fantastic. So great to see you guys fresh and ready for 2 days of madness. You're going to have more wrinkles and gray hairs by the end of it.
There is a beer fridge, though.
Oh, there is a beer fridge. And we also have a full-time barista at the stand, so that'll help us. Thanks, guys.
Thanks, Jim.
Good morning, Tamara.
Good morning, Jim.
Are you being personalized?
Absolutely. Personalization happens.
Hi, Veronica.
Hi.
So how do you think you're going to feel after 2 days of full-time nonstop hairdressing? Do you get cramps when you do something like that?
No, I'm used to that.
All right. We'll check in with you in a few hours and see how it's going. Michelle van Velde. How many shoes do you have on today?
Basically two today because we're rock solid and steady.
But that's not really on brand. Shouldn't it be your gag that you and your people just go around with one on?
Yeah, we should actually.
And how many idiots have made that stupid joke already?
In the last 10 years, because we were operating already for 10 years, I think practically every month that make 10 times 12 a lot.
Okay. Yeah. On the other hand, the last time I saw you, I gave a talk at the user group that you help organize, and total marketing genius, you gave me one chocolate shoe as a thank you.
Absolutely.
Very beautiful one.
Yep, a very beautiful one. Yeah, that's part of the trade, you know.
Do you have time to talk right now, or do you want to give me, I give you a few minutes?
No,
I'm right. So, look, we've got Fixies in Drupal Blue. We have a full-time barista, a tattoo artist is about to show up.
Yeah.
I guess we're going to have to admit that Drupal is just the hipster technology of the web at this point.
I think so. Absolutely. We've been working for the last 10 years to get it into this level, and I think we've reached it. Yeah.
Joking aside, though, we have quite a large booth at an enormous trade fair. They're saying that 50,000 people are going to be passing through our booth alone. Well, through the trade fair.
Yeah.
What are you and your agency doing here?
Basically, we promote our work. We are an integrated agency with a specialization in Drupal. So, basically promoting ourselves. We've just landed in Germany. We've opened up a shop in Munich. So that's basically the news we have here. Basically show the world what great stuff we make.
Talk about the connection, though. We're not here selling Drupal, right?
No.
What is it that we have to offer? And I guess I'm used to being at technology events and arguing about implementations or about CMSs or something.
Yeah. No.
What are we up to here?
Well, basically digital experiences. Because it's a digital event, so we're promoting basically the digital experiences, optimizing conversion, optimizing e-commerce. Basically, the integrated solution that Acquia and Drupal offer. And that's basically the same vision we have as an agency, deliver an integrated solution.
We're not here selling Drupal,
no.
Right? The word Drupal doesn't appear on the stand directly.
Yeah.
We're making a connection to bigger things, right?
I
know. So maybe I would like to think that we're a door opener to our technology. We're on a bigger mission here.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. So basically, Acquia has positioned themselves, you know, in between basically the big players in the world. We are an Acquia partner, and I think together with all other partners here, we have a very strong proposition against all those other brands.
So tell us who you are and what you do, and give us your shameless plug for OneShoe.
All right. Well, OneShoe is an integrated and advertising an advertising and digital agency. We combine traditional advertising with basically digital solutions, web and mobile. So basically what we do, we look at brands from a customer perspective. We create and design the whole customer journey. And from there, we start producing all the means that are necessary to fulfill the needs of that customer. So that's what we do.
Okay. And where does Drupal fit into that?
Everywhere.
Drupal fits in everywhere.
Yeah. But Acquia has created a lot of solutions that basically are enhancing those brands and enhancing the position of the customer. That's what that's what we're so happy about. And that's why we are an Acquia partner.
Nice. Okay. So the differentiator is this somehow this ecosystem with commercial and marketing oriented guarantees around it?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Great to see you, man.
All right. Very good.
Hey, morning,
how's
folks.
Going? How's it going?
Thursday at dmexco.
So, I think you can see there's just that little bit less energy than yesterday, both from the people working and from the visitors.
Well, there's a
lot of people.
So in real time, we've jumped through to Thursday at dmexco. Yesterday morning, I started recording here and ran into some technical issues with my camera and recording devices. It's really, really interesting to be here. We're at a trade fair of 50,000 people. Acquia has a really, really attractive booth. It's a quiet moment right now. But we've had a ton of interest and a ton of people talking with us and our partners about what we do, and therefore about Drupal. Acquia's big theme right now is around personalization and how we can deliver, you know, the right content to the right time at the right person. And to that end, we've had live tattooing going on, and believe it or not, 8 or 10 people came yesterday to be spontaneously, oh, hey, I'm going to take some swag, I'm going to take a sticker, I'm going to get a tattoo. So apparently that's a thing people do spontaneously. Also had a lot of people getting their hair done. I had mine done yesterday. We have a guy called Marco over there who's making absolutely amazing coffee. And I also think it's interesting, we've got this sort of hipstery look going on, and you compare it to all these people around us, and they've, I don't know, it's very, very corporate in this hall. So this is hall 8, and our neighbors are people like Amazon and PayPal and Oracle is down the road, and AXA Springer is a very large publishing organization. They're right here next to us, and Hubert Burda Media, who are not only a gigantic publishing organization in German-speaking Europe, they're also Drupal users who have made their own Drupal distribution called Thunder, which is super cool. They're here as well. So it's a pretty huge sort of a deal, and this is only one of three or four halls. And this is a hall with very, very large stands, and there are several halls with smaller things, you know, startup area and so on. Let's see if we can get a feeling for how many people are here. It's a little bit quieter this morning, like Jim was saying. You know, people are taking just a little bit longer to get started today than they did yesterday. It's a lot going on, though. Hey, so we are at dmexco 2016 in my hometown, Cologne, which is cool. This is the Acquia booth, which we've seen pieces of before, and here are some Drupal friends of mine. Why don't you guys introduce yourselves and tell us what you're doing here?
What we are doing here. So first, my name is Manuel. I'm from Pride Solutions. I founded the company based on Drupal. So we develop Drupal applications and mobile apps, and that's what we are doing here, talking to interesting people, seeing what other businesses do, and connecting with Acquia guys to develop further business opportunities in the future.
Me too. I'm Nico, also from Bright Solutions as an account manager. And it's pretty cool to talk with all the people here, seeing some other stuff they do and talking with them about Drupal, about the Drupal community. And show them what we can do for them, helping them, and it makes a lot of fun.
So, I mean, for me, it's been a really, really intense couple of days. There are 50,000 people here and all of these like massive stands and all this huge, like huge sort of castles, right? Like these booths, they're just incredible. I think it's cool that we're kind of doing it differently. First of all, I like that we're a sort of a whole ecosystem of friendly companies and we're just trying to do this thing together. But I'm really interested on your opinion, why on this booth, why is there no like huge Drupal logo? Why are we not selling Drupal, so to speak?
Because it's not an exhibition for technical guys. It's for more than just coding Drupal, building applications. It's about digitalizing processes. It's about digitalizing customer experience. It's also about cutting your hair and getting your tattoo. So that has nothing to do with Drupal, but it's nice and individual personalization as it is written here.
Right, yeah, so that's the joke. So indeed, I feel we're here to talk with people about business value, right? And we happen to get it done with Drupal, but that doesn't matter. And, per se. And the customer doesn't care how we do it if we give them the right thing. So I think it's an interesting perspective to link our technological perspective to this world where, you know, where these huge companies right next to us and we're sort of representing Drupal. I like that. Right next to them. How do you feel about that?
Are pretty cool because all the people here have any kind of problem. And it's cool if you see that you can solve this problem using Drupal and they even don't know it. Because you introduce Drupal, they don't know it, but they see how good it is and you show them the solution they need for their business or their problem, whatever they have. And yeah, when you can manage this, I think they are happy, we are happy, and it makes a lot of fun for all of us.
Drupal is happy too.
Yeah.
And Drupal is happy too.
You, Bright Solutions, have actually been doing Drupal in Germany for quite a long time. I'm also really interested in your perspective on how Drupal is doing in Germany. It's been less known than in other countries for a long time. How are we doing?
Yeah, and how are we doing in Germany? I think pretty well because it's growing. It's growing in the public sector. It's growing in the enterprise sector. Drupal came from very small sites, from complex applications as well, and today many web experience portals are built on Drupal, but not only websites, also e-commerce systems, community systems, and the integration of all of them.
Yeah. For me, it's interesting because Drupal is not famous here. Like if you say you do Drupal in some countries, people in business have heard of us. People in the US, people in the UK, they want Drupal. Here, nobody knows what I'm talking about, even though there's a lot of stuff built with it. How are we going to fix this problem?
First, I have to interrupt you because now we see that many people come to us because they need exactly Drupal solutions.
What?
this is something that changed during the last years, because some years ago we just need to introduce Drupal, what we can do, how great Drupal is. And now we don't need to introduce Drupal, we just need to wait until they come to us because they need Drupal solutions. So this changed a lot, and I think it's getting bigger and bigger during the next years.
Okay, awesome. That's fantastic news. It's been great to see you guys. Wait, no, stop. You said that again.
Do you know why that happened, what he explained? Because we meet more of these smart people. Half a year ago, he didn't even know what Drupal is. And now he talks as he would do Drupal 10 years, and he tells what are the benefits of Drupal, not from a technical perspective, but from a business perspective. And that's what we need. We need showcases. We need smart people that can transfer technical things into business value. And that's how to grow Drupal in Germany as well. Cheers.
As we say in Germany, meine Rede.
Or läuft.
Hey, so guys, it's been really, really cool to spend a little bit of time together. Really happy to see you. And, you know, shaking your hand now, which I'd like to do, is going to be tricky because I'm holding a camera in one and a microphone in the other.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.
All right, cool.
Very cool.
So cool.
Good. Okay. So, dmexco 2016 in my hometown, Cologne. How awesome is that?
It's very awesome.
We have had an incredible 2 days. We're almost at the end of this. I am with the, what do we call you, country manager?
Yes.
For the German-speaking European region, Michael Hoyer. Why don't you introduce yourself and tell us what you do?
So my name is Michael. I've been building up the business here since July last year. So when we started, there was literally nothing. And by now, we have about 14 people in the region. And we are, you know, here actually for the very first time with a real booth and getting connected with our potential customers, which has been quite successful over the last 2 days.
So talk about a little bit what dmexco is, because it's an unusual venue, and it's a sort of event that maybe not a lot of Drupal people have encountered yet.
Yeah, it's an event that has started, I think, like, I don't know, 5, 6, 7, 8 years ago. It was very small. So I remember I was here 5 years ago. It was mainly an online content marketing or online advertising type of fair. It has broadened a lot, so all the digital sales marketing type of players are here. Players means it's not just ISVs or advertising network companies, so here are agencies, here are software vendors, and so forth. So if you really are interested in what's going on in digital sales and marketing, then this is the place to be. I just saw this morning that they're like literally all the CEOs from the large media type of companies, from Facebook to Twitter, whatever, they're here giving speeches. Yeah, they have a booth here, a big booth. So they're really connecting the dots here between the different players in this kind of industry.
Right, so speaking of connecting the dots, we're at a trade fair with 50,000 visitors. It's actually a conference as well with sessions, and it's a huge, huge, huge event. Now, we are here as Acquia, and we've brought a bunch of partners with us. We've had a great time. But, you know, looking around our booth, we have this interesting explanation of who we do what for. We have some really fun. So we have this, our motto at the thing is personalization happens, and we have people being personalized live with hairdressers and tattoos. But, Michael, where's the Drupal?
Where's the Drupal? It's hidden. Well, no, Drupal is at the heart of Acquia. It's the heart of all the solutions we're having. However, you know, people are interested, you know, in technology. They're interested in doing something with it. So we're not trying to work from the fact like, okay, here's a piece of technology and we have enhanced it and we have did some extra services around that. It's more about what do you want to do. And a lot of companies want to do personalization. So they think about personalizing content. They think about personalizing the shop experience. They think about personalizing the email marketing or the emails they're sending out. And they want to utilize all kinds of information. So we were thinking about this. How can we get it across? As you know, we have a really good technology here, which is based on Drupal or connected with Drupal. Now a new version comes out, which we also use with any kind of other system, not only just CMSs, but also any kind of other web system. And so we thought, like, how do we bring it across? Because lots of companies are here talking about the same thing. So we wanted to make it really personal, the personalization. So this is the reason why we did this crazy thing. Yeah, our theme as Acquia is inspired a little crazy. Yeah, so this is what we did here. So we had a haircutter here, a hairstylist. We had this tattoo artist here from Cologne. He did a fantastic job. And honestly, I wasn't expecting really that so many people are volunteering here spontaneously at the fair to get a tattoo. So we lined up a couple of people who would do it anyhow.
We thought it would just be a show.
Yeah. And actually, the most asked question was, is this a real tattoo? Yes, it is. So I think this guy did like 12 tattoos now over the last 2 days. Yeah, we had about 50 haircuts in the meantime. And the second most asked question was actually, what are you really doing, Acquia? And this is exactly what we wanted to achieve, so that people are really asking us and we can talk.
Right, and it's a really great door opener. So the thing is, nobody cares about Drupal here, but we can talk really effectively about the things that Drupal has done for other businesses. So,
right.
So you know, and in this kind of market, security and scalability and everything that we and Drupal does really well is commodity, right? Mm. And so we get this opportunity to talk about business transformation. We get like to talk about our products, but also it comes back. I think we can close the circle very, very neatly. We have actual Drupal shops here who actually deliver Drupal. And I don't know, I think the exposure to this kind of argumentation in this is really valuable perspective.
Yeah, you know, the way I try to explain it, I usually talk about that a lot of the larger enterprises, they have, on average, that's a Forrester study, 268 digital touch points with their customers. So when you sometimes present that figure, they're saying, well, we don't have 268 touch points. Well, then we talk about this, like, okay, you have like how many countries you're operating with. So you have like 70 countries where you operate, you have 70 landing pages for the website. Then you have blocks, HR blocks, investor blocks, or sites, and so forth. Easily it adds up to lots of stuff. So then people start thinking about, like, where do we want to go? Because they want to go through the digital transformation like everybody. And so then they think, like, oh, how can I connect the whole thing? And this is where Drupal kicks in. So being open, being a system that you can easily connect to all kinds of other systems, where the Drupal community has done a fantastic job of connecting the dots again, here, and that you can use a headless Drupal to also provide content to any kind of device, which is really key for many players. That is something where they then finally understand that Drupal is really a key, or could be a key fundamental element of their future digital transformation strategy.
Right.
Yeah, and this is where we go.
Right. So, and I just love that we're not just selling websites anymore.
True. Yeah. Only 40% of the content is being delivered through websites. Yeah. So we have to. Yeah, and a lot of the other systems out there, without, you know, want to have a personal compete here, but a lot of the systems are really plain old web content management systems. They're not as modern as Drupal, not as prepared for the kind of future web, well, let's say, content distribution that you need. Mm.
So I do want to ask one more question about Drupal, though. Germany is really interesting in that there's actually a lot of Drupal around, mm-hmm. and yet in many cases nobody's heard of it. I was talking with Right Solutions about this before, and they said for the first time in the last year or so, people are coming to them and they say, we want Drupal, like you, and we heard you do Drupal, mm. but if I say I do Drupal, mm-hmm. out in the broad world, like, nobody's heard of it. So what's the state of Drupal in Germany today, and where do you think it's going to go in the next year or two?
I think it will explode, because in the past you had different CMS systems sometimes here in the open source space who have been quite successful. And we're not saying these are bad, but the business is internationalizing. It's going to be very difficult if you have a very local CMS system to find some developer in India, in Russia, in China, in the US. So if you go open source, you have to go for an open source system which is really broadly used, which is modern, which is backed up ideally by a company like Acquia. And
a huge Drupal community of service providers and practitioners.
Exactly. Yeah, so there's the other thing. You want to find a developer. And if you can't find a developer, and then how do you want to expand? So customers that we have here, Acquia, companies like Syngenta, as an example, global company, they want to have the ability to work anywhere with the system, and they can't just use something which might be a typo of the history of Germany. So therefore, you know, they're looking for something which they really can use everywhere.
Uh-huh. All right. So you're predicting Drupal explosion in German-speaking Europe?
Definitely.
All right. Yeah. I would love to be with you all the way there. Thank you so much. Hold on.
Thank you.
This is tricky for talking with me. It's been really a really cool 2 days. And let's get a stand that's twice as big next year.
We will work on this, yeah. So if any partners want to join us here, because it has been a great experience for everybody, then please contact us, because a lot of the partners really made like 40, 50 leads, you know, really good leads. So therefore, you know, it's a good place to be. Thank you.
Thanks, Michael.